Renee, and thanks for tuning into my channel. Today I'm going to show you 5 easy and convenient ways of how you can make your very own pet bed from home. All you're going to need is probably a baby gate, a bed, and a little bit of creativity. I'm making this because of my good girlfriend Rebecca gave me the idea, and I do have to give her credit. I told her I was making this bed a few weeks ago, and she says, why don't you do a pet room too? So I do have to give her credit. Another reason of why I'm doing this video is because I'm an advocate towards anyone who is helpless. That would be humans or animals. I have an enormous heart for animals. And the third reason of why I'm doing this video is because really my last video sound was horrible and I'm trying to redeem myself. Please stay tuned and let me know which example you like the best.
We're approaching example number one. So I have a baby gate up and then I have the pet bed that I made in the video before this, and on top is like a basket with flea treatment and some treats, and I put a food bowl and a water bowl in there, and then there's the bed, and I actually hung a leash right there, and then on top I put the food. So really in all one space you can have your food, you can have your animal, and one area, one confined area. And this is just one example that I thought was really, really cute. Now I'm gonna go show you another one. This is pet room number 2. It's a double-sided closet, and inside you can put your beds and some water and some food. But when the cats get bigger, you would probably have to close the door and not use the baby gate. I put a little sign up. You could do the same if you wanted to for your animals. And then I actually have a basket right here that's held with a belt that I don't use anymore, with pet treats in it and some flea medicine and some collars. But this is example number 2 to make the perfect little cute pet room. And here is my 3rd example. This is an American Girl doll bed. This would probably be good for a girl dog. And then I actually have some bandanas and some scarves and some scarves over here that actually just hung with hangers. And any small dogs would probably appreciate their own room like this. Probably a Chihuahua or a poodle or a Cocker Spaniel, an Italian Greyhound, a Maltese, a Terrier, probably a Pekingese, a Shih Tzu, and a Chinese Pug. But anyway, it makes for a great little area. And just remember, not all dogs do like to dress up, that sometimes they just dress up because they love you. So make sure that your breed of dog that you have enjoys dressing up. And here is the number 4th example. I put a little rug. It kind of makes it a little bit more homey. And you can see that it has a little nightlight there. So if your dog is afraid of thunderstorms or the darkness, it'll make them feel a little bit better. Now this table, I got this idea off the Pinterest because if you don't have a hexagon table like I did in the first demonstration, you might want to just find a regular table like this and cut off the legs and paint it and put a bed in there, or put a pillow, or you can improvise and put stuffed animals. But anyway, this is example number 4. Got a little food. See, there's enough for 2. There's my actors, but example number 4 with the pillow, and then you could use, you know, the top for some storage space with treats and flea medicine and things of that nature. And here is example number 5, and this is actually my entertainment system, and I'm going to show you why I love this so much. As you can see, an animal could actually walk back here and have their own food bowl. You could put some stuffed animals there if you want to. And it has its own space. And another reason why I like this area is because you're actually using your resources. So this is just really wasted space, and there's really no other way that you could use this area since the entertainment system is here. So it's a great way for your cat or dog to escape from reality. And they're just like humans. They like to have their alone time too, and their private time. And especially if they're older, they may want to take very long naps. So I just love this area that your cat or dog can come and escape when it wants to. Example number 5.
Which room did you like the best? If this inspires you to do your own pet room, please put your information down below in the details. I would love to see what you come up with. Also, if you like pets, give me a thumbs up. In addition, if you know anyone who likes pets or animals, please share my video. Have a great day.